So, no joke, right in front of my girlfriend, Grandma starts just going on about her bunions again, loud as can be, and, oh, I didn't see you there. Welcome, Facebook land. We are live from Harmony Hall here in Nashville, Tennessee, where you are witnessing the drawing for the order of the Youth Barbershop Quartet Contest. My name is Kyle Snook, and I am joined by my friend and colleague, Mr. James Pennington. James,
hi, Kyle.
Thank you for joining.
Yeah, thank you for letting me cut your hair right before we started.
It's my favorite time to do it. This is our second year now of doing this in a row, and we're like the Regis and Kelly of the draw, it seems.
I consider myself more of a Michael Strahan, personally, but...
Well, as long as I can be Kelly, I think everyone's happy. So... again, welcome for all of you who are joining us live. This is a cool and exciting way to kick off the event. It's changed quite a bit now. This is the 25th anniversary of the contest, and from the very beginning in the 90s, it was always pretty exciting, and now it's one of the premier events of the entire week, in my opinion. And actually, I'm going to do something now that I find very annoying when sports commentators do it, which is, you know, they're commenting on sports.
Yes.
And they like to casually slip in how they used to play sports, and so they'll say, oh, you know, when I was in the NFL, blah, 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 and they really are just trying to plug how they were in the NFL. So I will shamelessly say that you and I have both had the pleasure of singing in the Youth Barbershop Quartet Contest, formerly known as the College Barbershop Quartet Contest, and you have a fun little tidbit. The name of your quartet when you were in it was what?
The name of that quartet, if I remember correctly, was Instant Classic.
So, and it was the instant classic that you all know and love, probably. So, if you are interested in winning an international championship, have James sing with you for one season, kick him out, and then get way better and win. It's really quite that easy here, folks. To the stage, an experienced barbershop in some of the most beautiful forms, and for many of these young men, it's their first experience at a contest. So, for everyone who's a donor, thank you sincerely for giving these young men an awesome week.
We're gonna do the draw here in just a second. I'd like to add one more disclaimer. Kyle mentioned that I used to sing in the college quartet contest. I probably still could. I'm not too old or anything. We don't need to worry about that. Kyle actually is a member of a quartet that is participating in the contest this year. So I just wanted to throw a disclaimer out here before we get to the draw. We have a lovely little spread set up, and Kyle does not know where his quartet is in here. I don't either. I had a co-host lined up that I wanted to bring on to kick Kyle out of this part. Unfortunately, PK Subban was ready, getting the Nashville Predators to play in the Stanley Cup Final next week. So he didn't answer my calls. He never does.
Several people were like, I have no idea what in the world he just said. Hockey, sports, everyone. It's
we also... We also have two quartets, unfortunately, that were had a scratch from the spread. This spread,
the B Flads, and What in Harmonization, my favorite quartet name I've ever seen.
Unfortunately, they had a scratch, so they're not going to be part of this. So, boys, we'll mail these cards to you or something, because this is such a meaningful moment in your lives.
But we still have 23 quartets lined up here,
yeah.
And just an explanation as to how we're going to do this. So here's the table. We've got the spread here. James, on this iPad that you see here, he's going to pull up Facebook Live, and we're going to watch ourselves because we are that egotistical. And all of these cards on the back, as you saw James show, they all have a quartet name on there. And so we are going to use you, the viewers, have you participate, and you can comment which card you'd like for us to choose next. And... that way it'll be totally random, and we will just pick up the card, read the back of it, and whatever quartet is chosen will be the quartet that then goes. We will post the order and recap all of that in the comments and in the description, so if you miss some of it or you're coming in late, you will be able to see that all once this is all over.
Yep, and we made sure that this was all handled in-house by Jeremy Gover, who is currently behind the camera. He's waving right now, and you can't see him. Oh, there he is. Okay,
yes.
Great. We did not employ the accounting firm that was employed by the Academy Awards this year.
Too soon.
Though we did in the past, because we're high rollers here at the VHS and Harmony Foundation. Well, what do you say?
I think we're ready.
Okay.
All right, so audience, this is where you come in. We need you to comment away, give us suggestions, and say which card you'd like for us to choose.
Literally, the only choice so far is the Ace of Spades.
Wow.
Okay, Ace of Spades.
That's what we've heard first.
Shall we? Ace of Spades. Millennial Falcons, a reference to the movie Star Trek.
Yes, excellent. Wonderful.
It's blasphemous.
I love it. Good for them. A name that is actually quite loved by our own Jeremy Gover, the man behind the camera, a big Star Wars fan. And I do know a little bit about this quartet. They hail from the Johnny Appleseed district. And quite a few of them, a few of them have been in the contest before. David Breen, Will Bauman, the son of Randy Bauman, who was the bass in the 1997 champs yesteryear. So definitely some veterans to the stage, some experience. But as I understand it, their first time as a foursome together in this contest. So if nothing else, your name rules. So you've done a great job so far.
You've already
second
done
one.
Second. Five on red. There's only one red.
We aren't gambling, people. Focus.
Okay. Five of hearts is Polaris.
Yes. Boom. And I believe Polaris, they're the middle school quartet from the Southwestern
district.
Yeah, they
sure are.
They brought the house down last year.
Yeah,
I believe they were our first middle school group. And as many of you probably know, the BHS has done a great job of trying to diversify the amount of experience and ages for all the quartets. So hopefully we can keep seeing more young quartets like that up there and rocking the house.
Yeah.
You ready for card number three?
Jack of Hearts. Dean Moore the second
wants the Jack of Hearts. Well, Dean, you're going to get what you want, my friend. The Reunion.
Boom.
Yes. So our pals from the Northeastern District, they know who they are. Right.
Good job, Reunion.
They've been in the contest before. They sang, if I'm not mistaken, they were at the Youth Quartet Contest in Pittsburgh.
Nice.
And Francesco, if I'm getting any of this wrong, I'm sorry.
Is this their reunion? Were they in Nashville?
I don't know.
Horrible joke. I'll never use it again. Moving on.
Please don't concentrate too hard on these jokes that we're making. Some of them are not very good.
Three of Diamonds. Three of Diamonds is basically.
Oh, my goodness.
Basically.
Me. Basically, that name rules.
It's probably not pronounced Bass. Oh.
Nice job. Very good. So if you're just joining us a little bit late, I can remember so far the order, but I can't promise that I'll remember later. So first is Millennial Falcons. Second, Polaris. Third, The Reunion. And fourth is Basically. And again, we will recap the order.
And if you're watching this live, and get in the comments and tell us what you want us to draw next. We've got the Ace of Hearts coming up.
Nope. One more pause for dramatic effect.
Blindside.
Blindside, our boys from Australia.
That's right. I think this is their third time coming to the contest, if I'm not mistaken. They got fourth place, I want to say, in Pittsburgh. A young, exciting quartet. I've gotten to know a few of them a little bit here in the past year when they were here in Nashville. Mm-hmm. Great guys.
Yeah, they're awesome.
Thank you for traveling literally thousands of miles for Barbershop. You guys are awesome.
Yep. Okay, next, Jaden wants us to pull the Eight of Clubs. Well, Jaden, I'm sorry to report that the Eight of Clubs, that ain't in here. I'm sorry. It might have a good quartet on it. How about the Eight of Spades?
Oh!
I'm going to pull one anyway, even though you tried to pull a goof on me. Singularity!
Wow. Is that a science term?
Yes.
What is that?
Moving on.
All right. I really have no clue. Please help me if you know what the singularity is.
Okay, let's see here. Coming up next. Five. Yeah, Five of Spades. Yeah, that's in here. You guys are good. Boom. Frontier. Hey. Yes.
Very good. Gentlemen from the Pioneer District have been a few times before. They got fifth place last year. As I understand it, they got some new music that they've been working on. They will hopefully debut there in... Well, maybe not debut, but sing again. Mm-hmm. International, so congrats, boys, on making it again.
Hi, guys.
Rooting for you.
Frontier's awesome. That was the Five of Spades. That one's already been pulled. That one's already been done.
Danny Becker, get back to work. Thank you.
Six of Diamonds coming up. Gateway.
I've learned that I'm really good at reading upside down.
Well, congratulations. That's one skill you've got. I don't know much about Gateway, but congratulations on making it to the big dance, boys. Excited to see you up there.
This is the gateway to the Barbershop Harmony Society.
Oh,
right
my.
Here, the Youth Quartet Contest.
That was something special. We worked hard on that one. And I was going to try and recap the order. I have no clue what the order is. And if you're just joining us
we'll post the order later.
You may not either. It'll be up on the page and in the comments, so hang tight for that.
Scott Shipley wants us to draw five.
Just there any five?
Well, there are no fives left.
That's a problem, my friend. It seems that
Scott, can you be more specific,
in
please?
In fairness, he did follow up with two of clubs.
Oh, did he? Yeah. I'm not that far yet. Two of clubs. Let's go with the two of clubs. Scott, I didn't mean to embarrass you. Actually, I am the one embarrassed here. Two of clubs. This is the story of my life. And the electones. Sorry, there's no the. It's electones.
Also not that.
Eclectones.
Eclectones.
James, while good at reading upside down.
I just bragged about how good I am at reading.
He is. He can read upside down, but he can't read, period. So we're actually talking today about what it would be like to not know how to read. And that's all I have to say about
that. If anybody can't read, please type using language in the comments.
Is it like eclectic? Is that what that's supposed to be?
I have to. I don't want to project onto them what I think
well,
their name
I'm
is.
I'm certainly not here to argue. Let's okay. just move on. And
King of Clubs from Jeremy Williams. Jeremy, here you go, pal.
Oh. Ohana means family.
Wow.
Very good. I do know a little bit about these guys. A couple from the Nashville area. I know that Patrick loves the color purple and going on swing sets. No. They were fourth place last year, I believe. A couple from the Nashville area, Ryan Modrell, Patrick McAlexander, who you've probably never heard of, Kevin Mendez, mm-hmm. a veteran of the stage with the Academy, who won in 2014, and Robbie Black from the Southwestern District, who is very tall. And a great quartet. It's really nice that they have a built-in arranger with Patrick, and so I'm sure they'll do a great job this year. And excited to see.
And I also can say that while Kevin Mendez is a better baritone than I am, I did beat him at Mario Kart last week. So
and
which track?
Ooh, good question.
Which one didn't I beat him at?
Wow.
Fair enough.
And your afro,
for you, Kevin.
Your afro is also bigger than his at this point. So good job on that, James.
Okay, let's see here. Nope, that one's not there anymore.
For anyone tuning in halfway and they have no clue what you're looking at, this is the Youth Barbershop Quartet Contest draw. We are something like halfway through
it. Okay, here we go. We got
and,
one.
And shout in the comments for which card you'd like for us to pick.
Okay, well, next up, coming from George C. Jackson Jr.
Hey,
the
George.
Four of clubs. Are you ready?
Yes.
Boom.
Wow.
Western Harmonics, ladies and gentlemen. Western Harmonics. I'm not familiar with this quartet.
Not to be confused with the Eastern... Whatever the opposite of harmonics is. I'll work on that one for next time. Dissonance. Sure.
I was going to say dad wagon. But.
Okay, well.
That works, I suppose.
Five black. Nope, sorry. No can do.
Five
Scott.
Black. We need to work on our identifiers, it seems. Just five black. That's not going to work.
Here's a serious question.
Yeah.
All barbershoppers.
Sure.
They spend so much time singing.
Yep.
Have any of them ever played cards? Or looked at cards? Familiar with the concept of playing cards?
I'm going to say yes.
Okay.
And that's all I have to say about that. They okay. certainly, I mean, we hope you play. We're going to Vegas, so.
We're going to Las Vegas, yeah.
Did I tell you?
That's why they call it the city of cards.
I tried to gamble one time when we were in Vegas last time. And
yeah,
it consisted of me going to a blackjack table, and I said, I have $2. I'm going to see if I can make it to 10. Don't laugh at me. Look at you. No, well, here's the thing. I put in the $2, and mm-hmm. it said, $5 minimum, so I took the $2 out and I walked away. I didn't gamble, actually. I tried
you got
to
get your money back.
And I got my money back.
Yeah,
so I broke
good.
Even in that regard.
Yep.
So that's a success. I'll try and make some money this year.
Okay, good for you. I hope it happens. Ten of Spades. Ten of Spades coming up from Ron Brooks. Hey, Ron. On point.
Oh,
on point.
If I do say so myself, that name is.
On point.
That's all I got.
I'm not familiar with this quartet. I listened to the public radio show On Point.
That must be them.
Is Tom Ashbrook in this quartet?
Yes.
I don't think he's 25.
Yes, he is.
Okay.
And he's in there.
Okay, great. Coming up next, y'all are getting a really exciting peek into my life when I'm just scrolling through on my iPad, the internet. That was a really bad sentence. Seven of Spades coming up. Here we go. Rebels of Rhythm.
Oh, my goodness. I don't know what they look like, but I could just imagine some rebel jackets. We've got some leather. They probably all ride motorcycles. And they don't adhere to rhythm, apparently.
And they sing in odd time signatures.
We're almost done with the spades, it looks like, here, right?
Yeah, we're cleaning out the spades. Okay, let's see here. Scrolling through. Queen of Diamonds! Hey, all right.
A card that hasn't been selected yet. Here we go. California
Kid! Ladies and gentlemen, Kyle... T. Snook is the baritone of California Kid.
That's pretty good.
Along with Caleb Hayes and Stephen Goldman and Dalton Hughes.
That's right. Yep. Some
that's
a Belmont connection. So Harmony University takes place at Belmont just down the road. And all of us in that quartet either went to Belmont or are currently attending Belmont. So hopefully we'll do Belmont proud. And even if we don't, we have a cool name. So back off.
And what California Kid, who among you is the California Kid?
That's a great question. And we'll... I don't know. We have no clue. The name means absolutely... It kind of means something. It's a really horrible inside joke. Ask me about it sometime. It's not funny.
Okay. Okay, let's see here. Nope, that one doesn't exist. Nope, that one doesn't exist.
I'm reading one from Mr. Larry Munson. We've got to get that one.
He says
Seven of Diamonds.
Seven of Diamonds. This one's for you, Larry. All right, here we go. The Agonizers.
Wow. Wow.
Yes, Agonizers from Texas A&M University.
Yeah,
right?
I really hope they are, because if not, that's... I mean, that's perfect. Aggies, right?
Mm-hmm.
What is an Aggie?
You know.
Really, though, is an Aggie anything? I've never heard of an Aggie before or after
I think
that.
It's an agriculture, because it's an agricultural...
That's interesting. They really rally around that agriculture thing. That's kind of cool, I guess.
I did go to a Texas A&M basketball game once. And
are they any good?
Well, they have been in the past.
Okay. Bobby Knight?
That was Texas Tech.
I tried.
After he coached Indiana for 100 years.
Okay. I just know he threw a chair. Speaking of sports, here we go. Cards.
Okay. No, there is no one. Have people. Okay. Come on.
Jeez.
That one, no. How far back am I on this list? Jack of Spades. George Jackson. George, this is your second time that you've recommended a card that's still on
George
the list.
George Jack of Spades.
Here we go. Minor Details.
Ooh. Minor Details, I love
and,
it.
Yeah, so they're going to be wearing like hats with headlamps, right? The minor
it's
thing?
Really
is that where the name comes from?
The puns just never stop with that one, really. It's just, it's asking for it.
No.
Congrats on making it Minor Details. Excited to see you all
up
there.
Absolutely. It's going to be great.
Let's see here. Who keeps typing in 10 of spades?
I see one here. I see from Mr. Derek, King of Hearts.
King of Hearts. Yes, let's go with the King of Hearts. Flight Line. Oh, yeah.
Excellent. So I do know these gentlemen. They've been a few times from the far western district. As I understand it,
Daniel.
From last year, they were the quartet that placed the highest. They got second place last year. Did a fantastic job. They have a new baritone, Marcus Kang, who, as I understand it, is not bad at singing. So I'm sure they're going to do very well, even with the new member this year. And we'll see if they can do even better than they did last year.
Yeah, looking forward to seeing you boys.
All right, Four of Hearts is coming up next for our... The Brothers in Arms. Oh.
I think we've got a connection to that quartet, don't we?
Baby.
Wow.
Yeah, so...
I didn't know it was going to be on the other end of that.
So, some of you may know that we here at the Barbershop Harmony Society... have an intern or a couple of interns every year. We have one standing right back there. His name is James.
There he is.
Yeah. Well, last year we had an intern whose name was also James, and it was a totally different guy. And his name is James Isley. Did I say it right?
Yes.
Like the Isley Brothers?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And he is the lead in Brothers of Arms. And I think I've met some of the other guys in that quartet, but I don't know them as well as I know.
Okay, they're from the Mighty Mid-Atlantic District. Great guys. I think they know Sean Devine. That's reason enough to think that they're acceptable people.
Well, we can debate that. Let's see here.
So we're looking at, we've gone quite a ways here through the order, and we've got 5 cards left of the 23 quartets that will be competing. Continue to throw out suggestions. These are the final 5 here shown in the frame.
Now, we've been asked, Kyle, are we going to sing?
Are we going to sing?
Would you like to sing a 2-part tag? Record?
Yeah, as you well know, people who ask you to sing, if you don't have a quartet around you, it's worthless, because my voice is trash without 3 other better singers.
Yes, that's right.
So, at this point, I don't have the ability to do that. And the baritone part sounds hideous, and 2 of them together is death.
Just sing, sing a note. Sing a note. Yeah, we can't do it. With
thank you.
With
we'll try.
We need 2 or 3.
Later.
All right.
Was that my grandma? She always asks me to sing. Stop it, Grandma.
Don't
I told
make,
you to get off the stream.
Don't make me sing. Let's see here.
All right.
I think I'm really far behind because I'm just getting a whole bunch of.
All right. Matt Gorman has suggested something, and we just are not. We're just not
going to
escape that here. He said 6 of spades. Is that right? Because there isn't a 6 of spades. There is a 6 of clubs, though. So we'll just pretend that.
Yeah. You know what? I saw 6 of clubs on here from someone. So here it is. 6 of clubs is green light.
Red light. Green light.
Do you know anything about green light?
I don't know what just happened, people.
Okay.
Let's move on. We
I'm getting the signal to move on. Green light, we're looking forward to seeing you in Vegas, boys. All right, 8 of hearts. That's Murray Phillips. Hey, Murray.
Murray, hi.
The Tune Squad.
Hey,
Kyle, fill us in on the Tune Squad.
I do know a little bit about the Tune Squad from the Johnny Appleseed District. Their first time, they've competed in the preliminary contest a few times. Their first time making it to the big dance. I've gotten a chance to meet a few of them, and they're wonderful guys. My buddy John Lang, son of Mark Lang from the Hot Air Buffoons. So there's a couple of Hot Air Buffoons connections in here. So although they won't be here this year, they will live on in spirit through their sons.
They will.
Who are shorter and way less. I only say that because they always joke about their weight. So please don't think I'm really mean.
Ten of Hearts has been recommended. And at that recommendation, I will flip it over right now. Tradition!
Are they a Fiddler on the Roof quartet?
I don't know. Not to be confused with New Tradition, the chorus.
Yeah.
They are just Tradition. Just the plain old Tradition.
I believe
they're from the Mid-Atlantic District.
Okay.
I think our dear friend, Mr. Rick Taylor, has helped coach them a little bit. So I'm sure they're going to be well-equipped to have the skill set to put up a really nice score. And I believe one of our novice quartets, correct me if I'm wrong, but a great preliminary score from a novice quartet Tradition. And I'm sure they'll do really well come Vegas time.
We have two cards left. The Three of Clubs and the Jack of Clubs. Wouldn't it be great if one of these quartets was named the Jack of Clubs, but they were on the three card?
Well, that certainly would be ironic now, wouldn't it? I don't think that's going to happen, though. Let's just... No. Any suggestions? Which one should we pick first?
Three of Clubs came in first. Dalton Hughes says, Kyle, you're always wrong.
Dalton? You're barely in my quartet at this point, so don't mess around.
Three Clubs is Spontaneous Chord Busted.
Now, while
we tried to spontaneously chord bust a few moments ago, it didn't go great. Yeah. I think you guys are going to do a lot better job at it.
Yeah. Wanton Harmonization, well, that's a great name, but Spontaneous Chord Busting, that
the
is apostro- like,
the apostrophe is critical.
That's just like,
critical.
I don't know what meta means, but that's so meta, and I love it. Good job, guys. Did I use it right?
You clearly don't know what it means.
I don't know what meta means, but it's meta.
All right. Does anybody want me to pick the Jack of Clubs here?
Yeah, wait. Well, let's just get one person to say Jack of Clubs before we proceed. We don't want to do this without your
permission.
I don't want to
make any assumptions here.
This is funny. They're all going to be quiet. I'm just going to wait patiently. I can't whistle and laugh. This is funny. Wow. Well, we're just going to go...
Jack of Clubs!
JJ, get back to work,
come
my
on,
friend.
People.
Me and James aren't working. You need to get back to work.
At the recommendation of the audience here, I will now select the Jack of Clubs. Singing last in the Youth Quartet Contest in Las Vegas, Nevada, Sound Hypnosis.
Nice. That was my favorite move in Pokemon. Very good stuff. Love that name.
Sound Hypnosis.
What? Are you sure it was written down here wrong then?
Sound Hypothesis.
We're sorry, guys.
Okay.
But if you ever
think
about changing your name,
Sound Hypothesis.
It might.
We're looking forward to seeing you guys. Hopefully, they've moved past. What's the next step in the scientific? Formula.
I have a music degree. I have no idea.
What's the word I'm looking for?
No idea what's happening right
come
now.
Come on. I hope my wife is not watching this right now. She's gonna make fun of me.
Proof? Scientific
method.
Yes.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that. Well, speaking of science, that's it, everyone. Those are all 23 quartets.
That's science for you.
For the Youth Barbershop Quartet Contest. You can see them all laid out here. And again, we will have the order posted in the comment section and in the description. We appreciate you putting up with our just horrific jokes. And hope that we spent a good, however, 20 minutes of your birthday.
3 hours.
It certainly felt that way, didn't it? But enjoy the rest of your week, everyone. Head back to work. Looking forward to seeing you all in Vegas. And for Kyle Smith and James Pennington, we are signing off.
Bye, y'all.